Hello everybody. So for today, let us see Cannizzaro's reaction. So this is again another reaction which comes under the reaction of enolate ions. So this Cannizzaro reaction was first given by Cannizzaro, an Italian chemist. So he published his sketch of a course in chemical philosophy in Journal 2, Novo Chemeto, and he has also contributed towards the periodic table. Okay. So this particular person has given this reaction wherein an aromatic aldehyde that do not possess an alpha hydrogen atom on treatment with concentrated aqueous alkali undergo self-oxidation and reduction to give an alcohol and the salt of corresponding carboxylic acid. This reaction is termed as Cannizzaro's reaction. An example is given over there, and orthomethoxy benzaldehyde is taken. When two molecules of that substituted benzaldehyde is taken in presence of alkali, that is KOH, you can see that one molecule of alcohol, okay, so that is benzyl alcohol, and another molecule of respective salt of acid is obtained, and this would be the Cannizzaro's reaction. So these reactions are applicable only to aldehydes containing no alpha hydrogen, okay, and also this is having its own limitation that yields are very less. That is, as two compounds are formed simultaneously here, the yields of each particular, that is alcohol as well as acid, will be less than 50%. And also certain ortho and paraphenolic aldehydes, they don't show, or they are do not undergo Cannizzaro's reaction. And if the same reaction is carried out in presence of alkoxide, okay, so that is instead of KOH, if any alkoxide base is being used, then the product obtained is called as ester. This is again another named reaction, we shall see little later. Okay, coming on to mechanism of this Cannizzaro's reaction. So here it involves the formation of and reducing anion by the interaction of aldehyde with OH. The anion next transfers the hydride ion intermolecularly to carbonyl carbon. Okay, it transfers the hydride ion, okay, the hydride ion intermolecularly to the carbonyl carbon of another molecule, forming a carboxylic acid and an alkoxide ion. So here you can see the transfer of hydride happening from one molecule to another. The shift of proton from acid to alkoxide ion finally gives the product. So here you can see the shift of hydride taking place. Okay, so the next is intramolecular Cannizzaro's reactions, are also known, and here glyoxal gives hydroxyacetate anion in presence of alkali, that is concentrated alkali. The reaction occurs and we just get an intramolecular Cannizzaro's product, that is hydroxyacetate. Okay, so hydroxyacetate is obtained, and also a mixture of two aldehydes having no alpha hydrogen undergo cross aldol reactions are also known. When formaldehyde, which is more reactive than other aldehydes towards nucleophiles and rapidly gives high concentration of donor anion, the products are sodium formate resulting from oxidation of formaldehyde exclusively, and alcohol corresponding to other aldehyde occurs. Okay, so this is about intramolecular and cross Cannizzaro's reaction. Even aromatic substrates are known to undergo cross Cannizzaro's reaction. Before that, we shall just look into the mechanism. And mechanism is very similar. That is, it in first an reducing anion is formed by the interaction of aldehyde with hydroxide ion occurs. then the anion transfer hydride ion intermolecularly to the carbonyl carbon within the molecule it occurs, and then the formation of an acid, carboxylic acid and alkoxide ion occurs, the shift of proton finally results in the product. Intramolecular Cannizzaros reaction is being given here, that is phenyl glyoxal undergoes reaction by giving mandelic acid. Mandelic acid is alpha hydroxy phenyl acetic acid, or it is also called 2-hydroxy phenyl ethanoic acid. Okay, so this mandelic acid is having its own application. It is used in cosmetic industry. So it is known to act as an anti-acne agent for initial acnes, and also an anti-aging. This mandelic acid is known to act against wrinkles formed on skin. Thus, it is used as anti-aging in anti-aging products. So the next is the other applications of this Cannizzaros reaction. So here a tetrahydric alcohol, pentaerythritol, can be formed from formaldehyde and acetaldehyde, and it is called as actually crossed Cannizzaros reaction. So here you can see, and polyols can be obtained, and this pentaerythritol is an explosive, and also it is having many other applications, can be synthesized by Cannizzaros reaction. And this Cannizzaros reaction is used in industry to prepare different polyols. So moving on to another variation in this particular Cannizzaros reaction is Ichenko reaction. Okay, it is a variant of Cannizzaros reaction. It is a disproportionate reaction of an aldehyde which is lacking an alpha hydrogen, and the reaction again occurs in presence of an alkoxide ion, and here usually an aluminium alkoxide or sodium alkoxides are used, and this reaction will give ester, and this is called as Ichenko reaction. So the mechanism of Ichenko reaction is that aluminium alkoxide here acts as Lewis acid to coordinate with one molecule of aldehyde and to facilitate the addition of second equivalent aldehyde, generating a hemiacetal intermediate. This molecule undergoes intramolecular hydride shift that results in production of the aluminium coordinated ester. And this is about Ichenko reaction. Thank you.